The provincial government in Ontario just released some new grants for solar and battery storage for your home. Now, there was one clause in there that confused a lot of people and frankly pissed a lot of people off. So what was that clause? That clause said not compatible with net metering. Now, what they're alluding to here is that they will not allow net metering with these new grants. So what's your other option? Your other option is called load displacement. Now, in this video, we're going to talk about what the difference between net metering is and load displacement and which one's right for you. So net metering is the standard way we have been doing things for the past few years, which basically means during the day when your solar is producing more than your home is using, that excess gets fed back to the grid. The utility company gives you a credit for you to use at a later date, which typically means during the summer months, you're overproducing every day. You're building a bank of credits for you to use during the summer months whenever you will be typically underproducing because there will be cloudy days, there will be snow on the panels, just not ideal for solar. But with the net metering, we can still essentially offset your entire bill, your entire usage for the year, as long as we design the system to the right size. Sounds like a great deal. So why isn't the new grants eligible for net metering? Well, my suspicion is that the utility companies were tired of essentially managing our power and managing the billing for no profit, which makes a lot of sense. So now they're incentivizing us with a cash bonus of $10,000, well, $5,000 for solar, $5,000 for battery to go to load displacement. Cool. $10,000 sounds amazing and helps a lot. Could cover around 30% of the cost of your system. But what does it mean for the end user? So load displacement, what it means is you're only allowed to displace the load that your home is using. So during the day when your system is producing more than your home is using, that difference in production versus usage needs to be fed back to a battery or it's wasted. So makes a lot of sense if you have a battery. If you don't have a battery, I would rather go net metering. If you have a battery system, basically what this will do is your solar system is producing during the day. It's going to your house, heating, cooling, some appliances. If you're working from home, this might work better for you because you're using more power during the day. The excess production is being stored in your battery. At night, when you get home or whenever you start, you know, cooking supper, running your stove, running different appliances, typically there's a peak between 5 and 7, power jumps up. That's when you can start offloading the battery and doing peak shaving. It's a great deal. And the battery still gives you that backup power solution for when the grid goes out. So it's a great grant if you want to have that battery. If you don't want the battery, I think it makes more sense to go net metering. Because if you're only going solar, that excess production, you can't export it. You can't do anything with it. It is completely wasted. So you can only replace your baseline power during the day. I don't think it makes a lot of sense. I think you need to get the battery to be able to peak shave at night. That way, during the day, you're producing solar, replacing all your power, charging your battery. Then at night, you're discharging the battery until the battery runs to wherever you set it, either 30% depth of discharge, where I want to keep that minimum 30% in the battery for backup power. And then you restart the cycle during the day. However, this does mean that during the winter months, when your solar is not producing so much, you're probably still going to have a winter bill. So that those are the things to consider. Net metering contracts are still available for now. So I would say if you're a high power user and you don't want batteries, definitely go for the net metering. If you're not a high power user and you want the backup battery, go for the grants, go for the load displacement, and it's a great deal. That's my advice for you. If you guys have any more questions, drop them in the comments. I'll be happy to answer. Send us an email. I'm pretty easy to get a hold of. And we're going to keep you posted on all the latest developments in solar. Have a great day.